There's nothing better to get you through a spell of cold Maine weather than a nice hot soup. Lynn Archer from Archer's on the Pier in Rockland is with us in the 207 Kitchen at O'Maine Studios. We're making butternut squash bisque. You've already got it started. What's going on here already?
A couple of tablespoons of melted butter.
Yep.
And then some bacon.
Mm-hmm.
And give it a good stir so that your bacon starts cooking down. Then celery, carrot, and onion.
You are a big fan of your soups and bisques, aren't you? I really like them.
I love soup. I like what Aaron said earlier. It fills in all the cracks. It's just comforting.
Yeah.
It's warming. It makes you feel good. It makes your house smell good.
Yes.
And it's a good way to use up leftovers.
Mm-hmm.
You can make soup out of anything. And so this leftover butternut squash was, I cook a lot of squash and I like roasting it because
it
brings out a sweetness.
Yeah.
But, you know, a lot of folks still just mash it and put butter and salt and pepper and it is what it is. You can either use chicken base or chicken stock. I'm a great fan of chicken base.
Chicken base is what you just added there.
A paste.
Got it.
A couple of tablespoons. And you cook it. You cook this base down, the bacon, celery, carrot, and onion, until your onion is translucent.
Okay, I was
not brown.
Just about to ask, because I'm not sure how well we can see what's going on here. So when the onion is translucent, that's when you can move on to the next
step. That's when you move on to the next step.
Got it.
So, again, big fan of salt and pepper.
Pinch of salt and healthy amount of pepper, more than a pinch maybe of salt. To taste, as the saying goes.
Right, exactly. And the other beauty of this soup, too, if you're not a meat eater and you don't want to do bacon, it's not necessary. You can do it with olive oil. You can skip that altogether. So I'm a bacon person.
The other nice thing about soups and stews, especially in this day and age, is this is a pretty economical way to eat. You're not going to get much more for your dollar than by making good soups
not
and stews.
Not at all. Not at all. And you just put it right up on top of all that while it's still cooking.
How much, I mean, do you know how much you've got there? That's a very generous portion.
Well, you know, the other beauty of these kind of soups are you can freeze them. So if you have a lot left over, go ahead and make that kettle of soup because maybe you have a neighbor that you wants some soup or you know, maybe mom or grandma or whatever. Nobody ever says no to good soup.
That's a great point. And the fact that you can freeze them and keep them, that too works in your favor.
Okay, so in this instance, I used two stalks of celery, one carrot diced, one small onion diced, two strips of bacon diced. That's what I started with. And I'd say I put in about 4 cups of squash
just then. Okay.
And 2 tablespoons of the chicken base, or you would use 2 cups of chicken stock.
Okay.
So in that instance, of course, I have to add a little water, about a cup, maybe two.
Got it.
To barely cover the squash, just bring it up to the squash. Because the bisque part of this, the bisque best part of this.
I was aware of that really
bad
unfortunate pun.
Is I'm going to add some cream to this. And you can use half and half of cream, but I'm actually going to use cream. And you can see it's already breaking right down to become soup.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it until you add your cream. So we got to let it cook a little bit.
Okay.
10 minutes.
So we'd give this at home, if you're making this at home, about a 10 minute, just leave it on the burner, right?
Leave it on the burner. Let it come right up to a boil. And you'll see the squash will break right down so it's smooth. I know a lot of people use like immersion blenders and you can use a potato masher, but literally once this comes up to a boil, it will break down.
So we've given this about a good 7 or 8 minutes to let it heat up some more and break apart, and we're ready now for the next step, Lynn.
Right, so now we're gonna just add about 1.5 cups and we're gonna actually shut it off because you don't wanna boil cream. You're going to add about 1.5 cups of cream and stir it in because obviously it was boiling.
Right.
So it's going to stay hot.
Plenty of heat.
Plenty of heat. And even though we started with bacon, It doesn't mean we shouldn't put more in there.
Well, you know, you kind of read my mind there, Lynn, because as I'm looking over at the ingredients, and I see that there's still a hefty portion of bacon there, which has not been put to use.
What's wrong with bacon? So, a little chopped bacon, and a little shredded cheese. So it's sweet, and it's savory. It's comfort food at its best.
Butternut squash bisque. The recipe is on our website. Go to the 207 section of newscentermaine.com. You'll find the recipe for the bisque. You'll find more information on Archer's on the Pier, Lynn's restaurant in Rockland. That looks so good. Thank you.
Thank you.
Stick around. We are going to return with 207 in just a moment.